put a device here, maybe flip-flop, I mean, sorry, a floppy disk, hard disk, a floppy disk, or your pen drive, or any kind of external hard disk, or input device also, as input device also it can go, okay. Now, semiconductor memory can be classified in different ways, okay. Semiconductor memory have different way it can be also classified. Here we are classifying as random access memory and random access memory, which is called RAM. If you put a static, then we call it static random access memory. Anyway, another one is read-only memory. Read-only memory means you cannot write onto it after manufacturing, you can read only. So RAM or random access memory can be SRAM, static random access memory. It may be realized with bipolar and MOS. Nowadays, mostly it is realized with MOS, not bipolar or BJT. DRAM or dynamic RAM is realized with MOSFET as well as capacitor. Okay, I mean one capacitor, one MOSFET is required. One in MOSFET and one cap, storage cap. And here, six transistors is required. Six MOSFETs are required to realize on this SRAM. If you go with the MOSFET version, it will be realized 60 in the industry it is used. Nowadays, 80 also being fabricated. Now, going to ROM, read-only memory. It was RAM, first one. It is this RAM can be read and written to it. Data can be read from RAM as well as data can be written onto the RAM. Okay. Whereas in case of ROM, you can only read. While manufacturing, actually you are storing the data. Okay, or making, constructing in such a way that while manufacturing or fabricating the chip, it is written, data is written, and then you can only read later on. It is having three types here, PROM or programmable ROM. It may be realized with bipolar and MOSFET, but mostly nowadays, MOSFET, bipolar is almost obsolete. Then erasable PROM. First one cannot be erased, rewritten, okay? But here, with ultraviolet light, you can erase the previous content and you can write the new data onto it. Okay. But it is cumbersome. I mean to say, we have to arrange the ultraviolet light. Okay. And you may have to take out from the board in which your EEPROM is installed or connected. So that problem is there. So, not easy to rewrite. Here, EEPROM, or sometimes called E2PROM, is electrically erasable. It was UC, ultraviolet light. Ultraviolet light, ultraviolet light. Ultraviolet light is used to erase. Here it is electrically, as you can see here. Electrically erasable PROM. You can remove the content and again rewrite it. For example, your it is also called flash or flash memory, also called Flotox. Flash memory. And MOSFET itself is having a floating gate, so it is also called Flotox. Floating gate oxide based MOSFET, and it can be electrically erasable. Of course, for erasing, you have to apply higher voltage, maybe 12 volt or so. Like your pen drive is having the Flotox or flash memory. These are the basic semiconductor memory and its classification. We'll find later on different ways also to classify the memory later on. RAM we are showing here in the left figure. You have in this data in. So n number of bits are there for data to be stored. Okay, and you have n number of bits for taking out or reading out the data from the memory RAM. You have control, read control, write control, and enable control. Three control signals has to be applied. If you want to read, then read control has to come along with the enable. And if you want to write, then write control has to come. Okay, then write operation will happen. The address lines will come as an input here. Okay, input. These are all. This address lines will be coming here, and based on the address, memories are actually arranged in row. Okay, so zeroth location, one location, two. You can write in binary also. So it may be having you may be having say 1010 kind of information will be stored here. Say maybe 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 bits are stored in a one location. So address is suppose okay, 2 bit of address is coming here. Okay, so 2 to the power 4, 4 locations can be accessed. Okay, 4 location altogether, and every location is having 8 bits or a byte. Okay, in your 8085 processor, it will be a byte of information will be stored. And how many this kind of rows are there in 8085? Okay, it is it's address bits are 16 bit. Okay, 16 bit address. So how many locations can be found? Tell me. 2 to the power 16 is equal to 64 k locations. Are you understanding? 2 to the power 10, 2 to the power 10 is 1k. 2 to the power 10 equals to 1k. And it is what? What is the value here? 2 to the power k, 1024. 1024. It is not 1000 exactly. Okay. In decimal system, 1000. But here, 2 to the power 10 means 1k and 1024. Okay. So if 16 address lines are coming here, suppose in the address inputs, then it means that there'll be 64 k means 64 into 1024 locations will be there in which one byte will be stored. Is it understood?
Yes, sir.
It will be dealt with later on also in microprocessor, but let me give a little hint here so that later on also these things is useful. So this is what addressing is. You have to point to particular location in the memory, and in that location maybe 8 bit or 16 bit or 32 bit will be stored. In case of particularly in case of 8085 processor, which you will be studying later on, is having 8 bit of information. One byte is stored per location, and it can address up to 64k locations. Nowadays it is used, of course. Nowadays processor is having a lot of memory. Anyway, so this is about the left figure. Right figure is telling only one enable signal. Okay, here address lines is going to come. That may be 8 bit address or 16 bit address, possibly 16 bit address, and output will be n bits of output. If suppose each location is having, like, you know, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, so 8 bits in the form of 1 0 1 0 1 0 1 0 1 0, in this way bits are stored, data bits are, or instruction bits are stored, and then 8 bit will be outed from here. Remember, from the output 8 bit will be outed. If I say that a byte is the storage capacity in a one row, then 8 bit will be outed, same content of the each location will be outed. Here you see that that read and write operation is not given because it is read only. So you don't need read control. Once you enable, the content of the memory will be placed onto the bus, and through that bus will be outed to the out data outlines. Is it understood?
Yes,
here, little customary about the memory is given here. It is customary to refer to the number of words or bytes in memory with one of the letter K, kilo, mega, M, capital M, and giga, G. K is equal to 10 by 10 means, and M, this equals to what? 1024. And mega is equal to 10 to the 20. Are you understanding? That means what? 1024 into 1024, you can write. Isn't it? Then giga is to the power 30. Okay. Thus, what is written? Thus, 64K equals to the power 16, and 2M equals to the power 21, and 4G to the power 32. Is it understood? These are the notations of in memory. When you are talking about memory, it will be indicating this thing. Yes, Pratham, are you understanding?
Yes, sir. Clear.
Consider the, for example, the memory unit with the capacity of 1K watts of 16 bits is. 16 bits is shown here in this case. Since 1K equals to 1024 equals to 10, and 16 bits constitute 2 bytes, we can say that the memory can accommodate 2048 equals to 2K bytes. These notations is given in the book. You just read yourself also. 1K to 16 memory of this figure has 10 bits in the address lines. Okay, 10 bits in the address line and 16 bits in each word. As another example, 64K into 10 memory will have 16 bits in the address, since 64K equals to the power 16, and each word will consist of 10 bits. The number of bits needed in memory is dependent on the total number of words that can be stored in the memory and is independent of the number of bits in the each word. The number of bits in the address is determined from the relation to the power k greater than equals to m, where m is the total number of words. These are each word. Each one is one word. Okay. Normally, if it is 16 bit, then we call word. If it is 1 bit storage capacity per row, then we call byte. If 32 bit is stored in a word, then we call a double word. Okay. So this each one is a word that may have 16 bit information. Now, memory, whatever I was telling earlier, RAM and ROM, those are semiconductor memory. Now, another kind of memory will be there, that is magnetic memory. Magnetic memory is, earlier it was magnetic tape. Like have you seen the cassette of songs? Cassette? Yes, anybody? Cassettes, have you seen? A thin film? So, it was earlier like this. In the plastic material, plastic based magnetic material be applied in one side, like a film only. I mean, which is in two pulleys, it is wounded. Okay. So this is now obsolete. Long back in the beginning of the history of computer, it was used. And another magnetic memory is the hard disk. You know, hard disk is a rigid disk, is aluminium platter, kind of circular platter, like a plate. That is not circular, but it is a circular hard. It is rigid, and it is maybe more than one platter will be used to store the information in hard disk. And a semi-rigid disk is used in case of floppy disk. Floppy disk, I think you have not seen. Have you seen anybody floppy disk? It is also obsolete. Magnetic tape, long back, it was obsolete, and floppy disk was in use. I used, I think from long back, maybe 20 years back or so. I was having computer in that two kind of floppy drive will be there. One is smaller, 3.5 inch or so, and another is 5.25 inch or so. So that is a semi rigid, I mean, kind of film, you see, film, I mean, photographs you are doing, that kind of film, have you seen?
Yes, sir.
That Konica or that kind of film. That kind of film, one side is applied some material, magnetic material, emulsion, we call it emulsion. So similarly, in that floppy disk and hard disk, I mean, floppy disk and two type of floppy disk, in that magnetic material will be applied, and that is a little harder than a tape. That's why it's calling a semi-rigid disk. And in this system, I mean, how the thing is stored. See, coil is on here and current is flowing. That is creating a magnetic field. And that magnetic field, some of the magnetic field is applied when the magnetic core, magnetic base along with its layer, magnetic oxide, is moving. Then if some current is flowing, then it will be magnetized. Okay, if direction of the magnetization, you see the recording will be recording of one in figure B, recording of one, and current flowing is one direction, that recording one is going to happen. And if current is flowing in other direction, the magnetization of that magnetic material will be taking place in opposite direction. In this way, recording of one and zero can be done in this. Same thing. And reading on writing also, writing, you see, recording means writing only. Here, reading can be done. See, the floppy disk or tape having the stored data in, and it's a tiny magnet, is magnetized in particular direction. So based on that direction, if you are moving the tape or the floppy disk, then when that magnet will come near to the coil, I mean read-write head, in read-write head coil will be there, then that magnetized one or zero in a particular direction current will flow. Suppose in this direction current going up, and in this direction current going down. With this, you'll be able to understand what was written in that floppy disk or magnetic tape. Okay, one or zero. Okay. See, in a tape or say that kind of magnetic memory, total 8 tracks are there, where 7 tracks are for data, say one character you are storing, A or B or C, corresponding to that ASCII character, and one bit will be for what? Parity. We have discussed it a little bit about the parity. So whether it is on odd parity or even parity, doesn't matter, it will be there. And after reading, you can understand what character was stored there. Is it understood?
Yes, sir.
These are very basic and certain things are obsolete. Of course, still hard disk is there. So hard disk, you see, that is a circular platter, and in that you have the circular tracks. So in a track, middle and inner track and outer track, etc. There, and this portion is called one sector. Yeah, sector. If you look at the hard disk sometimes and its configuration in your laptop, you see that it is written, and this terminology is written, especially sector will be there. So what are the size? And I was telling that 3.5 inch was the floppy disk size, Chota, but it was having more capacity. Another one is 5.25 inch diameter. And the hard disk speed for our desktop computers or laptop, hard disk speed is around 7,200 RPM revolution per minute. And in high speed, and in server, this of server, it is 15,000 RPM, resulting in the access time, read access time, for example, so 16 milliseconds to 3.6 milliseconds. For this one, of course, high speed, so less access time will be required. I mean, it has to rotate, no? The platter and the hard disk are rotating in a high speed, and your read and write heads are there. So to reach up to a particular location where from you are reading, it needs a certain time. Okay, that's called access time. Access time. Typical access time for this your desktop computer is 16 milliseconds. Here is this floppy disk. It is a 5.25 inch floppy disk or mini floppy disk, and this one is micro floppy disk. It is called. Here is the index point, and it is placed, and it is there will be protruding things, and it will fit here. It is a hole is there, and write access is through this. There will be hole. I mean, it will be having a jacket. Inside that jacket, it is put. Outside, from outside, it is not accessible. Only access, you can see the film through this wall. And write protection notch is there. If you are sliding the write protection notch, then nothing can be written onto this also. It is both applicable for that. So, double-sided high density 5.25 inch disk have capacity of 1.2 MB, and double sided high density 3.5 inch this have capacity of 2.88 MB. Anyway, these that disk or memories are obsolete nowadays. Nowhere you can find, even nowadays CD drive or DVD drive is also not coming. It is getting obsolete gradually. Now, new memories are coming. CD drive and CD drive can store up to about 700 MB of data, and your DVD can have a capacity of 4.7 for single sided and single layer. In double sided, it is 9.4 GB. Anyway, these are very silly things for you. You can understand yourself because you are using also sometimes. Are you not using?
Using, sir.
Using, so related to that, how it is done? It is written here. You can, if you want to, laser is used in a shiny and glossy disk. How data is stored is written. Yeah, intense laser beam is focused on very small point on the disk, CD. The heat from this beam burns a light diffracting pit at that point on the disk. Digital data ones and zeros are stored on the disk one bit at a time by burning or not burning a bit. If you're burning a bit, I mean, sorry, pit. If you're burning a pit, you are able to create a pit. I think from outside you will not be able to that much observe, but a pit is created for storing a one. Not no pit means you are storing a zero. So in order to read data, a much lesser powerful laser beam is focused onto the surface of the disk. At any point, the reflected light is reused as either either a 1 or 0. Okay, this is all about the CD and DVD. We will go ahead now. Little broader or another perspective of classifying the memories. I said that it can be classified in different way. So this is another way to classify memory. Can be classified as RAM, CAM, and serial memory. Okay. Three way we have the classified. Then RAM can be volatile and non-volatile. Volatile means if you keep on giving the supply voltage, it is semiconductor memory. All are semiconductor memory, remember. Volatile means once you are giving the supply voltage, it is going to retain the content 1 or 0. But once the supply voltage is off, then content will be washed away or removed. So volatile are two types, SRAM and DRAM, static random access memory and dynamic random access memory. Okay. In non-volatile means if you remove the supply voltage, still it will be able to retain the content. That are four different types, like, you know, flash ROM, then your pen drive is kind of flash ROM, MRAM, magnetic random access memory, RRAM, registry random access memory, then PCRAM, phase change random access memory. Four types, non-volatile are there. And another, serial memory can be shift registers and queues. Okay, queues having FIFO and LIFO, first in, first out, last in, first out. And shift registers, just now we have discussed, it is parallel in, serial out, or serial in, parallel out. These two types it can be. Okay, shift registers. We have discussed shift registers. I think you will be understanding this. Yes, Pratham? Somebody's microphone is on. Please switch off. Somebody's microphone is on. Please switch off. Look at your microphone. Okay. So that Harsh. Harsh Tripathi,
yes.
Are you there?
Yes.
What
yes,
happened
sir.
To you?
Sir, I overslept.
Okay. Anyway, so don't do that. Don't miss the class. So, shift register we have discussed thoroughly. Parallel in, serial out. Parallel in, serial out, and serial in, parallel out possible. We have studied. Then another memory type is CAM, content addressable memory. Normally, in this memory technology, you are searching the content by sending the address. Okay. Okay. But here, content is sent to search it. Okay. Content and content addressable memory. What is written at the top right corner? Let us see that. Shift registers, processor registers, data buffers, and other. What is processor registers? Data buffers and other small digital registers that have no memory address, decoding mechanism, are not considered as memory, although they also store digital data. That's a brief notice given. Sometimes if you don't have address to access the content, and that is storing content from one register to another register, simply transferring the content, that may not be considered as memory. That's what it's telling. Now, what is next? Memory decoding. What you saw is type of memory now. Now we are going to talk about types of memory. You have seen, understood various kinds. Semiconductor memory can be divided into different ways. And then magnetic memory also. You have a magnetic tape, floppy disk, two type of floppy disk. One is micro and mini floppy disk. Mini is having the capacity of 1.2 megabytes. Its size is 5.25 inch. Yeah. And micro is having different size, 5 inch. Anyway, so read all those things, basic things. Then memory decoding. Suppose you have the content in the memory stored, it is how you want to decode, or you can read it. You can get the content of the memory, or you have data you want to write onto the memory, how you can do that. So it is not simply possible without some circuit, okay, which is called memory peripheral circuits. Okay, so we are going to now discuss about the memory peripheral circuits along with the memory, how to read and how to write. Okay, some very fundamental things. It's very important also, remember. If you don't understand at this level very basic things, then in future understanding will be difficult. Okay. See, ROM 8x4, ROM is shown here. 8x4 ROM, designed with diode and gates. Okay. Look at this and try to get some insight into the memory. If there is a switch, of course, it will not be practically switch like this. Maybe an older computer it will be, but now that switch is replaced with decoder, address decoder. We'll see that later on. But here, what is there are 8 rows, and each row is having 4 bits. Means each row can store 4 bits, and there are 8 rows. Okay, that is row 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 5, 6, and 7. So 8 rows are there, and each row can store 4 bits. Say now the switch is at location, say 0 location. See that rotary switch, 0 location. In 0 location means address is 000. There's 8 address line, lines at rows. To address this 8 rows, you need 2^3 address bits. Okay, so which gives you 8 and 0 to 7, 0 to 7, 8 different locations can be addressed with this. So what is written into this row 0, let us try to understand. Okay. See, a diode is connected to this. Let me call Y3, Y2, Y1, and Y0. With the row 0 line, a diode is connected to Y2 line, and another diode from row 0 to Y1 line, another diode from row 0 to this Y0 line. There is a missing diode from row 0 to line Y3. So 5 volt is going through this switch to this row 0 line, and to the diodes, it is a forward biased. See that ground is there at the bottom. Okay, a resistor is there and ground is there. So diode is forward biased, and hence the 5 volt here, 5 volt is connected to the Y2 line. And there is a voltage resistor, so a voltage will be developed here. Okay. Y2 will have some voltage. Maybe 5 volt will be here. If you have resistance at the bottom. Whereas Y1 also will have some voltage. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
Y,
sir.
Y0 also will be having voltage. But what about Y3? So this is 1, this is 1, and this is 1. I means 1. Okay. What about Y3? Y3
zero.
Is not?
Zero.
No. Yeah, 0, because it is not connected to the supply, row 0. It is not connected to row 0. So you can say that at row 0, okay, row 0 is having the address 000, and it is storing currently 0111. Okay, so let me ask a question. What is stored in row 1? What is stored in row 1? See the connection central.
1000.
Because row 1 is having, now it is placed here. The switch is placed here. So this row 1 is having high voltage, and the Y3 line is connected. So your next data stored into the row 1 is 1000. So what is stored in R6, for example? Tell.
1001.
R6 means the switch is placed into this position, rotary switch. So this is a 0. There is no line here connecting here. A missing diode here, and here also a missing diode. Okay, so 0, 0. So here it is 1. It is 1. Is it not?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So understood how bits at a 0 or 1 can be stored in a row, and it can be read afterwards. Okay. While fabricating the chip, you are making somewhere diode, somewhere you are not making diode. Okay. That is the presence of diode indicating 1, absence of diode indicating 0. Is it understood, Pratham? Yes or no?
Yes.
Presence of 1 in the in this row connected to the vertical lines. Presence of diode is 1, absence of diode is 0. In this way, you can permanently store the desired content into the ROM. Once the chip is made, you cannot, write further. Diode is already made and chip is in your hand. Then you can only read the content. How you'll read? You'll be switching the moving the switches in particular row. Means you are selecting the row and you are getting the content of that row. Is it understood, Bushra? Bushra Akhtar, absent? Tanay Kumar? Ramin Kumar? Anish Raj?
Yes, sir.
Anish Raj, are you understanding?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. Well, go ahead if you have understood. So, to read the content of ROM, what do? You supply the address. Okay. Then a particular row is selected and you get the content of that row. That means you are reading the content of that row or of that address. In that address location, whatever content is stored, you are able to read by just supplying the address of that. You are switching the moving the switch means you are selecting particular row. So how we can realize this switch? Can anybody say how we can realize this switch, rotary switch, with a circuit? We have to give only 3 bit of information, and then it must be able to give us, according to the bit pattern, address bit pattern, should make one row high at a time only. How it is possible? What circuit is required for that?
Yes, my question. Could you understand what? Circuit can realize the rotary switch here. To address appropriate location. Abraham. Tell. Pratham.
Sir, thank you.
Harshdeep Bhatti.
Sir, maybe sir. Dimax.
Maybe Dimax. Okay. Dimax. Yes, somebody?
Multiplexer.
Huh?
Sir, it's a demultiplexer.
Demultiplexer.
Yes, sir.
Sarvesh Divedi. Shubham Shurana. Vedan Singh. Wait, Shubham Shurana.
Yes, sir.
So, can you suggest some circuit that can realize this switch, rotary switch?
Sir, I'm not sure, sir. Maybe Dimax, sir. Sir, I'm thinking, sir. Some okay, might be Dimax.
Keep on thinking. Dimax is what? Multiple input. One input, multiple output. Max is multiple input, single output. Is it like that? Bushra is absent today? Karthik Rai. Shapnil Goel. Utkarsh.
Yes, sir.
Who is that, Utkarsh?
Karthik Rai.
Karthik Rai, tell.
Sir, I think it's a demultiplexer.
No. Let us go ahead.
Sir, then decoder.
Yes, you're correct. It is decoder. You're correct, Karthik. Good.
Yes, sir.
See, you are giving 3 bits of input here. Okay. This inputs A, B, C will be your that table. 0, 0, 0. And when 0, 0, 0, which line will be high? Tell me in this diagram.
Sir, first.
First row, that is 0th row will be high. And you can read the content here at Y3, Y2, Y1. The content of row 0. Then if you apply 0, 0, 0, 1, then which one will go high? Which row will go high?
0, 1.
Okay, second one, second row. So let me ask. I am sending the address 1, 0. 0. What is the 100? What is the content I'll get here at the Y3, Y2, Y1, Y0? Tell me what is the content? I'm sending this up 3 bits of information at as address, and I'm reading the memory content. Now, what is the content of this ROM? I mean, what is the content when I read this? Tell Y3, Y2, Y. What is that?
0, 1, 1, 0.
Is going to
Y3 will be 1.
0. 1, then by 2?
0, 0, 0.
0, 0, and 0. So, 1, 0, 0 means your 1, 0, 0 means this row? Row, which row? No, row number you tell? Which row will be? Which row will be high? Is it not this row? Row 4? Row 1, 1, 0. This is correct answer. Who is that, boy?
Aman Kumar.
Aman Kumar, why you are not interacting with me?
Yes,
Aman.
Yes, sir.
Keep on interacting. Otherwise, how will come to know who is what? In the class, we do it. It is very important from your angle. It is very important. So now, next is, suppose I am sending the address. Also hot in this case, in this example. Quickly, Aman.
Sir, 1110.
1110. Fine, very good. Let us, I think you have understood that the rotary switch can be realized with a decoder. It is called address decoder. Remember, this part is address decoder. Or you can say a row decoder. It is called row decoder. It is a of memory, peripheral circuit of memory, row decoder. Similarly, column decoder also may be there. Sometimes we will see later on. Now let me go ahead. The same thing is there. And so I'll skip. Now, we are going to
understand very basic things of memory, and you have studied the
kind of SR flip-flop, so you'll be understanding very clearly. For reading and writing, what are the controls required? That is also to be understood. We have also given some clue that read control, write control, and enable signal should be there. Have I done it or not? Aman?
Yes.
So, Why those control that in the block form I have given the control, okay? It was a block, and I was telling that as a read control is there, write control is there, and one enable control is there, okay, in that block. So actually inside the block, how it is going to work? The side was input, data input coming in to the block or memory block. This was the output, okay? Output, and here you had the address, okay? This was the things I have shown you at the beginning. Yes or no? It is RAM. If it is ROM, what will not be there? Tell me.
Read and write.
Read, write, control should not be there. Not necessary. So why it should be there? Okay. Now why these controls are required? Let us try to understand with this small circuit, okay? See that you want to suppose write something, then what will do, or read something, Suppose it is having some content and you want to read it. There is a queue and it is queue bar. Okay. You want to read. So what you want is you are giving a one here. Read oblique write actually is a write bar. Read write control only one line. So either it may be one or zero. So you are reading, so applying a one. Okay. This is one, so it is zero. This is zero. Am I correct or not? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Now select line you make high. Enable. This is nothing but your enable we have talked about. Okay. Just now we have talked about that is enable. So select line is one or enable is one. So this is of course one, but you have input maybe say one only right now. Okay, this is zero. Whether select line is one or input is one or zero doesn't matter. The outputs are always of this AND gates are zero. Zero both. Isn't it? Am I correct or not?
Yes, sir.
So 0 0 in SR flip flop is a which state?
No change state.
No change state. So input is not able to affect the content of the memory that is SR flip flop. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
When you are reading, you are ensuring that during that read operation, no change should occur. Whatever was stored that you want to get. No new input should come and disturb it. Okay. You have decided to read the content of the previously stored data. So this read one is ensuring that input is not affecting the data. But now how it is reading? Let us see that. To the right side, the output AND gate. You have one here because select or enable equals to one. Read is one. Now, if Q is storing previously one, then it will be one. So output is one. If previously Q was zero, then output is also zero. Is it understood how the read operation is to be performed and how internal it is doing?
Yes, Pratham.
Yes, sir. Clear.
Clear.
So control for read operation is select equals to one, read equals to one. Okay, input doesn't matter because it is going to read the stored previously stored data. Input is not going to affect the stored content. Okay, now write operation. For write operation, you apply read oblique write bar equals to zero. It is for read. It is for write. Okay, for write operation. So once you are applying a zero, let me take a different color. Okay, I'll be removing those previous contents. Okay. Now you are reading. Okay, writing. Okay. So what you will do? That will be describing. You are writing. So you are applying a zero here. Okay. Zero is going here. That means for output, when you are writing, output is no, content of the memory is not important for you. You need, nothing should come on the bus or output line. So zero is coming in very early. Whenever you are going to write into the memory, content of the memory or register will be all zero. So output is zero because one, zero has gone and gate it is. So output is zero. Now zero, so this is one. Sorry, it is one. Am I correct? This is one. Select is one or enable is one. So this is one. So now data you want to write is say one. Okay. So it is zero. It is one. So what is going to be content at Q? Tell me.
One.
It is going to be one. Okay, if you want to write a zero, then it is zero. Q is zero. So in the flip flop, reset flip flop, this now we have studied. So in this way, you can write a bit of information either zero or one and read the content of the memory. So this is the basic fundamental things. You need some control to have to be applied to ensure that while reading, the input is not able to affect the present content or previously stored data. And while writing, you are going to ensure that output is not important, so it should be always in. Now, in a small, block form, this is the BC bit cell, which can store a one bit of information, either 0 or 1. It should have select or enable line. It should have read or write control. Okay. Input should be there. Data to be written. Data in, you can say data. Data in and output and data out. Data out. So understood. This simplified block diagram is understood or not? Hereafter, we are going to use this same block, small block, which is having three inputs actually, out of which two are controls. Read, write, bar is a control, select is a control, and input is a input. So these three are input to the SR flip flop here, okay, or the memory block or BC bit cell. Every bit cell is having three inputs. Two are control. One is data input, and another one is output. Okay, data out. Understood, everybody?
Yes,
now,
sir.
With that concept and understanding, we are going to design a 4x4 RAM. It is read and write both possible. So it is random access memory, not ROM. See, row decoder, you have the, suppose, there are how many row? Row 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 rows are there. So address lines, how many bit of address is required here? Tell me. Quickly, Aman, Karthik, Aman,
sir, how many do?
Two bits will be there, but 2 to the power 2 equals to 4. So 4 outputs will be there of this decoder. And memory enable signal is given here. You know, enable signal is required sometimes. Okay. If you disable it, I mean, apply 0, then output will be always 0. So all the outputs means what 0, what 1, what 2, what 3, all will be 0. So enable control is also given to the decoder. Okay. Decoder, basic decoder. I don't know whether we have used the decoder with enable or not. Was it there? Decoder was having enable signal or not? With decoder, we have realized some other circuit also with the help of with the help of enable signal and inverter. Have you done or not? All forgetting. Should I again show? Yes. You forgot that enable signal also. Sorry. Enable signal may be also there. I'll be showing you, okay? You are forgetting nothing, you're remembering. You have to give the exam. But you're not in a decoder.
Yes, sir, adders and subtractors. We realize.
Yes, then you're not remembering anything. You're okay. I'm going to. Hmm. here is the decoder. Okay. Then there is the enable signal at the bottom. Are you able to see? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
At the bottom. There is a enable signal or not? Strobe or enable is written. Yes. Yes. Aman.
Sir, it's a multiplexer. It is a
multiplexer. Realize 4-to-1 multiplexer circuit. Okay. It is a multiplexer. Okay. So we'll be talking about decoder also. Enable is required for almost every gate. It is taking time to. This is what? Demultiplexer. Demultiplexer. This is also demultiplexer. This is what? Decoder. 2 of 4 decoder is having the enable signal here at the bottom. Seeing that if enable is a 0, output is what? Y0, Y1, Y2, Y3 is what? Yes.
Zero.
All 0. Okay. So, initially, if you want all outputs of the decoder or all rows are 0, then you have to apply this control. So, with this, you can make other circuit also. I was telling that with enable signal and one inverter, you can realize some other circuit. Okay, see that 4 of 16 decoder are made with 3 of 8 decoders. If you don't have that enable signal, then you could not do. Do you agree or not? You could not do anything. So decoder is having a always studied earlier. So we'll skip and go to that place once again. Here is the this is the thing that is. So this enable signal is there basically in a decoder. That also that can be made, but it may be much useful if you connect a or provide an enable signal. So if you give address say 00, so this row, what 0, W, we normally in case of memory we say what line, this will be high, what line will be high when address is 00. Am I correct, Aman? So this select line, this is a select line. Okay, select line of the bit cell PC, and suppose you want to write the data. So data input are coming here. In this 4 data lines are coming. Are you understanding? From the top. So this is input to be written onto the bit cell. And from the bottom, what is going? Read or write bar. Read or write bar. If you want to write, you have to make it 0. Okay, and that will enable writing. Okay, and gates at the input side will be having 1-1 because of the inverter there. And this is understood. This one input also, and this is coming from the top here. And output is remaining. Output is coming out of this if you apply this address, then output is or content is from row 0. If you are applying say 1 1 address, the content will be from, tell me which row?
Word 3.
Word 3, or this is going to be high. So content of this will be coming to the OR gate. Remember, these are not a single line. These all are not single line. It is having how many line? Tell. It is not single line. It is 4 rows, so 4 line will be there. It is shown only 1. Are you understanding this thing?
Yes, sir.
It's a 4 line. And OR gates also having 4 inputs. So with this, are you able to understand how to read and write in a memory? Based on your address lines, you are reading the content of particular row. Okay? Here, each row is having one nibble. Nibble means 4 bits. In your 8085, it will be how many? 8 bits. Okay? A byte. In modern processor, it will be maybe 64 bit also. Okay? So, concept is here. And same concept is applied to whatever processor you want to discuss or whatever memory you want to discuss. Okay? Is it understood, Pratham?
Yes, sir. Clear.
Okay, clear. Let us go to next thing. Now, here 16x8 ROM is discussed. Now, let us see whether you want to complete or not at the time. Oh, 10:15. So, I have to stop. We'll discuss in the next class. Is it understandable or is it... Yes, Pratham, what do you say?
Understandable.
Easily understandable or very difficult to understand? What do you say?
Say yes? Easily.
Easily? Okay. Easily understandable, then okay. Shouldn't have any much problem.